Moscow and pro-Russian separatists have rejected the idea of UN peacekeepers for eastern Ukraine. The Ukrainian government requested international troops to help enforce a shattered ceasefire. Renewed attacks by separatists force Ukrainian troops to abandon the town of Debaltseve. Ukraine's president says a UN force is needed because pro-Russian rebels repeatedly broke the truce signed just 4 days ago. Russia and the rebels say the Ukrainian government is only trying to destroy the ceasefire agreement negotiated last week in Belarus. CBN Disaster Relief is on the ground helping the Ukrainian people. And Brian Scott joins us now with more. You've just returned from eastern Ukraine. Why were you there?
Ephraim, I was there to see the disaster relief that CBN is providing in the eastern part of the Ukraine. We were on the ground for 2 days to see actual disaster relief as we provided food, water, medical supplies under the barrage of artillery, actually.
Wow, unbelievable. What are the conditions the Ukrainians are enduring?
Well, currently the Ukrainian winter is extremely cold and severely terrible. There is also the shortage of propane gas. There's the lack of water. There's the lack of heat. There's the lack of actual good food. People are not able to work or be employed in their circumstances, so they can't take care of themselves. CBN has come along to provide immediate relief through food, water, clothing, all the necessary above things to assist our Ukrainian brothers and sisters.
Well, tell us about some of the work that is going on even as we speak.
Well, right now we are actually doing multiple things. We are not only providing physical relief, but we're building houses in Ukraine. And during the day, we actually have vehicles traveling into the eastern part, not only to deliver refugee assistance, but we actually drive refugees away from the combat zone.
Wow, are there any other provisions CBN is offering?
At this present time, we're offering financial, spiritual support, and the opportunity to share the gospel in difficult times.
That is beautiful. Yeah, the gospel is being shared. How is the war and destruction affecting their spiritual life?
Well, at this present time, a majority of the Ukrainians are actually turning to the gospel, and they're turning to Jesus, and they're turning to the things that are really important and significant. They understand that the country is being torn apart, yet they also realize that Jesus is the one true being that they can have hope in.
Indeed. What should we pray for when we pray for them?
We should be in prayer for the opening of the gospel to continually work among the Russian people, as well as just for peace to occur in the hearts of the people who are in the conflict zone, and that people would not give up hope. That's the one thing that was in great short supply.
Indeed, indeed. Brian, thank you so much for your time. Much appreciated.
Thank you, Ephraim.